Hello all, welcome back to this session. In the previous session, we discussed introduction to NVH and hope it was informative. In today's session, we'll be looking to the units of vibration and the relationship. To start with, basically vibration is represented in displacement units. That said, any unit of length like millimeter, centimeter, kilometer can be used for representing displacement. To make this analogy a lot more visual, I would put this in a better perspective. Imagine a car standing in a position or a standstill position and moves to the next position. And this distance it covers, let's say it covers 1 kilometer. This distance it covers could be represented as distance or displacement, and thus can be represented in any length unit. Now to take this analogy a little forward, that we now see the car standing in a position has moved from A to B, but we already know that other than the distance it covered, it also took some time to cover this distance. So typically this gives two dimensions. One is the distance it has covered and the time it has taken to cover this distance. So putting these two units together, we can see a displacement or a distance divided by time, or displacement and the time consumed to make this distance. So we arrive at this new unit called velocity, which is displacement divided by time, or the time taken to cover a particular distance. The importance of using velocity as a vibration parameter has a number of significance, and we will discuss this in our next sessions. So combining these two, displacement and velocity, there's one more unit that can be associated with vibrations. We looked at the parameter of displacement and the rate at which the displacement is changing, which is termed as velocity. And now we look at the rate at which the velocity itself is changing. That is to say, if there is the same, we can go back to the same example of the car standing in a fixed position, moving to the next position. We looked at the distance, and we looked at the time it takes to reach from A to B position, then we call it as velocity. But we all know that a standing body or a standing vehicle to move from its static position and to achieve a designated speed, let's say you want to go at 10 kilometer speed, to reach the 10 kilometer speed from zero, it is going to take some small time. So at that instance, this is a change in velocity that's continuously happening. So the rate of change of the velocity that's happening will be termed as acceleration, and now this is represented as meter per second square, kilometer per second square, and so on. So with this, we have seen three units, which is displacement, velocity, and acceleration, and all these units will be used in its real application based on the relevance and significance. Now, after looking to these three units, there are two other dimensions that get associated with the basic dimensions of vibration. For the reason that vibration is a repetitive quantity which has got a periodic pattern, for example, a sine wave, a random wave, a stochastic wave like an impulsive wave, all of them have a pattern, which means these are very much connected with these two additional dimensions called frequency and phase. Let me explain what is frequency and phase. A simple example of a pendulum explains the basic definitions that we said about displacement, velocity, and acceleration, and also will connect better with the relationship of frequency and phase. Frequency typically represents the number of cyclic movements an object makes with respect to its equilibrium position, and this is represented as cycles per second or hertz as well. Phase, on the other hand, describes relative timing between two signals, or a phase difference between a reference point and a measured point within the signal. And with this, the units of phase would be degrees or radians per second. We will be able to use all this information together that I am saying this with respect to the units that we described for vibration, like displacement, velocity, and acceleration, combining with their relationship of frequency and phase in all the applications that we would be discussing further on. In the next session, we would make introduction to the transducers that are used in vibration measurement, their merits, their limitations, and how to select them. Till then, take care, and we will see you soon. Bye-bye.